Nice. There's a multiplayer here. This is settings. Change the land extension mode. The four, right? First one, front. Okay, how I go back? Okay, save. Challenge. I'm not experienced, but oh, come on. Let's go with challenge. Oh, look at the area outside. Beautiful effect on the glass. Let's go with challenge. Okay, I'll just turn off the mic because there's no point into my voice, right?
There. Oh, my. Feels like I've been asleep for years. I suppose you're wondering what this is all about. I remember your aunt being just as surprised. Allow me to introduce myself. My name is Arbitrix. I am the master of the table and a prodigious teller of tales. And you, my friend, are about to embark upon quite the adventure. I hope you're ready. The storm came out of nowhere. The ship is on its way back to the biggest port in the Crown's Islands. Its voyage has been a success. The substantial treasure on deck was, let's say, acquired by four scoundrels who hired the ship for their venture. Who are they, you ask? Pick them up and see for yourself. Captain Frost, commander of this ship. Not exactly one of the scoundrels, though. This is Hammer, a violent thug who's really good at solving problems with her ironclad fists. If you want to know more about a scoundrel, place them on one of the plinths on the table edge near you. Introducing Horatio Nine Lives the Thrice Blessed. The swindler came up with that name himself. This one calls herself Nuna. Don't ask where she got her heretical and very illegal powers of dark sorcery. Shouting nonsense into the wind. The crew aren't happy. They've bewitched the captain, yells First Mate Barnabas. And brought this storm upon us. We must take the ship for ourselves. This is mutiny. A band of heroes would try and talk the crew around, but these are scoundrels. The best way they know to end a mutiny is to put it down. You must spend all your yellow power pips to move, attack, or rest in order to defeat your foes. These mutineers were supposed to help your scoundrels return to civilization with their ill-gotten gains. Now it seems they're attempting a little skullduggery of their own. Move your scoundrel next to a foe. If you move too far, you'll begin to expend their power pips. And attack. To explain. comes up from below to join the fight. Unless someone revives them. in range to expend power pips and give them a boost. Of surviving this storm. Try to choose the best scoundrel for each task. The more stars they contribute, the better. Place them on the skill checks and see for yourself. Roll the die to find out if you succeed. briefly, but as the ship lurches in the gale, they're thrown painfully to the deck. The mast is creaking ominously. Someone fast needs to climb the rigging and trim those sails. Trimmed the sails, slowing the ship and saving the mast. Well done! Someone smart to tie a better knot. Waving that pistol around with a mad gleam in her eye. Someone needs to talk sense to her. She looks at them, the way a teacher looks at an annoying student. Calm? Oh, of course I'm calm. Calm as this ocean. From the captain, then. And to think, these four paid to hire her ship. You've done all you can for now. The ship's as safe as it can be. And just as well as a giant wave is about to roll over the deck. Brace for impact! I've always wanted to say that. Unfortunately for these scoundrels, there are only enough safe handholds left for three people. Going to be washed overboard. The question is, which one? It's up to you who fails to hang on. Once you've made your decision, pick them up and throw them overboard. beneath the waves. Only three scoundrels left. Knowing them, their first thought is that this means a larger share of the treasure. There's no time to mourn or celebrate. You've survived, but your ship's badly damaged, and you're not alone. That's the Sunfish, the personal vessel of Solomon Sanko, governor of the Crown Islands. He's taken a battering from the storm. Though, it's still in better condition than your poor ship. Wait, those aren't sailors. They're orcs, the most feared pirates in these seas. The governor and his captain are tied up on the deck. The orcs clearly don't want you interfering with their plans. Prepare to be boarded. Blasted away one of the orcs. We'll be right back. himself and he's found his pistol. From Captain Starling. Together, the scoundrels and the captain free Governor Sanko, who thanks you all profusely.
Your ship's in no shape to sail. You should come with us to the capital,
offers the governor. the governor's right. Your storm-battered vessel is headed to the bottom of the ocean. It seems the scoundrels have no choice but to bring their precious treasure aboard the Sunfish.
Excellent, says the governor. Take the cabin next to mine. When we get to Half Arch, you shall be properly rewarded for your bravery.
Half Arch, capital and largest city of the Crown Islands. Home to fishers, traders, smugglers, artisans, privateers, and scoundrels.
Come with me,
insists Solomon Sanko. The governor is determined to make good on his promise. Later that day, after a feast in his estate, the governor surprises the scoundrels with something they never thought they'd experience. Fame and glory.
All hail the heroes of Half Arch. Thomas Terlinger, brilliant apothecary dedicated to helping others. This is Hammer, warrior of true conviction and strength. Nuna the Wise, who protects us with mysterious powers. Unfortunately, our heroes can't stay for long, so let's drink in their honor. Without further ado, let us begin the Heroes Celebration! The heroes, leaving already. That's a shame. May we meet again in equally joyful circumstances, Captain Starling says before excusing himself. I hope you had a pleasant evening. The heroes of Half Arch are always welcome in this city,
says the governor before he's called back into the hall. After a round of farewells, the scoundrels slip away. Though they've lost one of their number, they've gained a second chance. They agree to split the treasure equally and go their separate ways. Time for your award. Choose a new ability and it's yours. Thomas Elsa praises the treasure with a keen eye, weighing his options before scooping several stacks of coins into pouches and leaving Half Arch. Using a deceptively humble pouch of precious gems, Nuna slips the treasure inside her sleeve before leaving, hopefully to a remote, peaceful island. Shoves a few bars of solid gold into her rucksack before leaving Half Arch. She doesn't know what her future holds, but she's never been one for making plans. And with that, the treasure chest is empty, and our scoundrels, heroes, go their separate ways, vowing to put their scoundrel days behind them. And they did. Well, at least for some time.
Wow, dudes, this was just the beginning. Quite awesome. Seriously cool game. Heretic. From scoundrels to heroes. Nice game. The scrawling upon the table. This is so cool. Solomon Kassankore elected. Very nice game, 7 years later. Oh. Come on, can I stop for a while? Just to
7 years is a long time. Long enough to build a whole new, quieter life. Tonight the scoundrels return to Half Arch for the first time since that day.
Oh, over here!
It's Governor Sanko.
Quickly, we may be watched.
A figure darts from the shadows and stabs the governor.
Oh, no.
This is very bad. You must find out why the governor summoned you.
Okay, I think I'm done for today. Very detailed, very nice game overall. It's just here, a table of tales indeed. Just in front of me. Okay, let's see what we have here in options. Huh? I press the options button, nothing. Huh? What the fuck? Oh man, how did I didn't use this yet. To bring the... my controller was lacking some... It was drifting away from me when I extended my arm all the way there. So much easier now. Okay, this is cool, but... Oh, wait a minute. Ah, it's the triangle button. Can I quit menu? Does it save? Can you save the progress? We'll be lost. I think it saves automatically, right? Yeah, I think it does. Very, very nice game. I'll just give you that. Okay, here. You can continue the adventure at any time. Very beautiful, lovely, truly lovely game. I've had some run-ins with Timon Games before in mobile games, and I've played some of their conversions from fighting fantasy games before, from the 80s, right? But now they've come with their, I think, their own thing, and very nicely done. Very cool stuff here. Okay, that's it for today. It was just introduction, just a, let's say, tutorial part. And still quite a lot of gameplay here. Very nice. You choose with your cards, you roll the dice. Yes, a very, very role-playing game, table role-playing game, right? Very beautiful, very consistent. I enjoyed it a lot, but I'm not continuing today, it's late already. Bye.